Okay. Again, salam alaikum. How are you? Guys, my presentation is, does customer education improve destination image and intention to visit risky country? Risky country between two brackets, Lebanon, Egypt, all the Arab world. An application to tourism in Lebanon. I am glad to tell you, this is the first ever research, not in the Middle East, but in the whole world, to discuss customer education in tourism. What is customer education? We will see what is customer education. Okay? Tourism. We are here all in tourism. But do we actually know what is tourism? Anybody of us spoke about tourism? Did they? Actually, no. According to UN WTO, in 2013, tourism was the second industry in the world after oil that generates profit. Do we know that? No. But actually, with regret and unquestionably, as our doctor said, it is the most fragile industry. If you have boom, all the tourists go home. And at the end, what is this? It's just a wheel of a truck. Because tourists, they're paying money to enjoy. They don't want SARS, they don't want Ebola, they don't want guns. They are here to relax. Okay? So, what are the most important factors to promote tourism? I have heard a lot of people talking about promoting tourism. But guys, what is promoting tourism? How can we actually promote tourism? I don't know. So how can we? According to Etchner and Ritchie, 1993, for all of you, this is the most cited article, international article, about tourism in history. Here. It's the most cited. If you want to speak tourism, we speak about this. By 2002, he made a study, a review of 142 articles from 1973 till 2002. Now we are talking how to promote tourism. Etchner and Ritchie, they taught us how to promote tourism. How? Destination learning. The image of the destination. When I say Sharm el Sheikh, what do I, the first thing I have in my mind? Sea. Beach. Right? No. Yeah, beaches. The first thing is resorts. When I say Cairo, when I say Cairo, I say the pyramids. When I say Paris, I say to the Eiffel. That's what I have in my mind. Customer perception. The most important factor. I have an article is, receive what do you perceive. I give perception to tourists when they come. It's not good. We have the best food. We are in the service industry. So it's all about people, process, physical evidence. We say food, and at the end, we have to go and eat in KFC. So when you tell something to your tourists, do it. Give them about the image. As all the prestigious speakers spoke about, the image of Cairo now, of Egypt. It's not good, but it is safe. Do you know that Egypt is safer than New York? Do you know that Egypt is safer than Athens? But no one is not going to New York or Athens. Do you know that Beirut is safer than New York? That's what we should teach our tourists. I have seen tourists in Beirut, women walking all by themselves, alone, at 4 o'clock in the morning. Can they do it in New York? Can they? Of course not. Destination learning. According to Gardner, destination, the image of Sharm is based on 3 factors. What are they? First,
Allah.
We develop an image in our minds. What is Jalam Sheikh? We develop in our mind. It's called cognition. Cognition is the sum of all factors. When we go to the travel agency and they tell us, okay, go to Alexandria. What is Alexandria? If I have watched a movie for Abd al-Halim Hafiz, I will know Alexandria. Then I will go to Alexandria. We should educate our customers. Affection, then we have different alternatives. One, two, three, four. And then we choose from one of them, right? The third one, the final thing is we decide which is cognitive. Actually, we'll see a lot of factors, but those are the most famous three. Customer education. Why is customer education? Why we need to teach our customers? Dr. Islam, you have your mobile, right? Can I ask you a question? Do you know how to use all the benefits of your mobile?
No, of course.
Who knows how to use 100% of the benefits of his mobile? Please raise your hand. 90, 80, 70, what even 60? None. We will see example now that is amazing. What is this example? First, what is customer education? I think my voice is louder than the mic. Okay. The biggest mistake a business can do today is not educating our customers about our business, about our product, about our service. As Dr. Mufida said, we have a lot of potential. Are we using them? No. Even I have heard to a presentation from Jordan. They have amazing things. Are they using them? No. In Lebanon, we have more than 10 ancient castles. In Athens, only the Acropolis, that is smaller than one of our 10 castles, and they're profiting it billions of dollars a year. Are we doing this? Unfortunately, no. So, the father of customer education is Mir. This is the definition of Mir. And since I paid 2,200 Egyptian, I can say it. Any purposeful and sustainable and organized education or training, learning activities, we should teach them. Okay, Samsung. Listen to this. Samsung introduced the NFC. What is the NFC? When you have two mobiles and when you hit them together, you can transmit information, right? Only 2% used this. You know what Samsung did? After two generations, they promoted this feature and they raised their sales all over the world by 15.34. They had an amazing option and they looked out that people are not even looking at them. So they used it. This is the model I have. Customer education. Teach your tourists about education. Customer knowledge. Let them know your destination. Image vividness. They will say, wow, I will go to this destination. And finally, they are willing to go. Okay? Listen to this carefully. If you come to an office, a tourist office in the Middle East, the first thing they tell you, let's go to 74.38 of them. They will tell you, let's choose the cheapest destination or the destination that will pay the highest commission. When you go to Europe, what do? They educate you about the destination. They tell you, this destination is better than that, is better than that. Why? They should teach you about the destination. They will tell you, in Jordan you have Petra, you have the Dead Sea, it is the lowest point in the world. So come and visit us, right? Professor Arabi, exactly. hypothesis. My three hypotheses were, the more educated about the destinations, the better the tourist knowledge, the customer knowledge. The higher customer knowledge about Lebanon, the more they know about Lebanon, about Jordan, about Egypt, the more vivid the image. What is vivid?
يعني جميل. الصورة جميلة برأس التورست.
Finally, the more vivid, the more willingness they are going to visit Lebanon or Cairo, even if they have a political instability. The first hypothesis was validated. The second, unfortunately, was not. The third was validated. Conclusion, finally, the second was not validated. Although, if we have knowledge about the destination, we should have a better, if we have education, better knowledge. But because this destination is risky, it was not recommended. This was a great added value, although it was non-validated, it was a great added value of the study. It showed the importance of promoting destination. If you want to promote destination in any country in the world, in Egypt, in Jordan, in Lebanon, use customer education. We will help you how to use customer education, how to let tourists be educated about Sharm. They know that you have diving, that you can dance with the dolphins. Okay? That you can, what you can do?
Safari.
Safari, as Dr. Jamal told us, Dr. Islam said, I want to do safari, and I'll be the first one. The third one, as Dr. Hamid said, it's about effective communication between all stakeholders, government and the private sector. It's not accepted to work separate. The government should unite with the private sector. And I heard something very encouraging in the evening session about the president of the Egypt is encouraging this. It should be together. Okay. The last one, finally, something called country of origin image, COI, what does it mean? And you see how many researchers, they have spoken about it, that improve the image. Tell them Beirut is not dangerous. Tell them if you are a lady, you can walk at 4 o'clock at night in the street, while in New York, if you walk at 4 o'clock at night, you will be raped, you will be killed, and then you will be thrown in the garbage. You're not a lady, why are you afraid?
For the ladies.
Thank you for your listening. I hope it was a good one.